detoxifying wholesomeness. Today we're just going to look at a part of the story of Ruth. So let me just set this up. So Naomi, she was a widow, and her two sons had become married to some women named Ruth and Orpah. And later both of the sons died, so the three widows just decided to live together. And then later Naomi decided that she should return to her homeland. And her two daughters-in-law, they wanted to stay with her, but Naomi gave them a very long list of reasons why they should go back to their families and remarry. And she thinks that the girls should go back to their own lives in the hopes that they will be more successful. So the first daughter-in-law, she followed Naomi's advice, and then she left, which is where we pick up the story. Ruth chapter 1, verses 15 through 17. Naomi said, "Look, your sister-in-law has gone back to her own people and her own gods, and you should do the same. But Ruth said, don't force me to leave you. Don't force me to go back to my own people. Let me go with you. Wherever you go, I will go. Wherever you sleep, I will sleep. Your people will be my people, and your God will be my God. Where you die, I will die, and that is where I will be buried. Ask the Lord to punish me if I don't keep this promise. Only death will separate us." And let me just say, wow, that is some fierce loyalty right there. And you don't see that a lot. A lot of the time we might identify with the first daughter in the story. As soon as problems rise up, we just want to move on with our lives. But Ruth decided to stick with Naomi without knowing what lied ahead, without knowing if they were going to make it, leaving everything that she ever knew to travel to a new place where she had never been. And this reminds me so much of every single other story in the Bible where God told someone to do something and they would do it even though they knew that the risk was high. The risk was high and they didn't care because they knew that they had God. That same kind of faith that Ruth had to stick with Naomi, Abraham used it too when God told him to take up his son Isaac to the mountain to be sacrificed. The same kind of faith that Ruth had, Moses used it too. He just was watching over his father-in-law's flocks when God told him to leave everything and go back to Egypt. That same kind of strong loyalty that Ruth had, Nehemiah used because he didn't give up on building the wall of Jerusalem no matter what got in his way. And that same kind of strong loyalty, that same kind of strong faith lives within us all. That same kind of faith that says yes to God despite the risk, even though you don't know what is going to happen next, it is your decision to trust God and to put your fate in his hands. Because God knows what is going to happen next. He knows the challenges that you will face. But what do these upcoming challenges have that they can use to even stand a chance against our God? And that is why these people said yes to God, because they knew that no matter what came their way, God would never leave them. He has shown himself over and over again as a provider and a protector, not just for them, but for us today as well. Thanks for watching this video. Please remember to like and subscribe. If you have any questions or anything, please feel free to leave them in the comments because I do read them and I want to hear from you guys. I'll see you guys next time.